a day in Washington, D.C. is very dynamic. You never really have a whole lot of time to sit in any one place for any significant or prolonged period of time. So I wake up very early in the morning, and then I typically receive a text message or an email from my staff reviewing my day. I put on my makeup, put on my best clothes, and I head out. I drive myself. And I drive from my apartment in Washington, D.C. to Capitol Hill. I arrive in the garage where I have a parking space, and then I walk over. We have a series of tunnels and office buildings that make up sort of the Capitol complex. And I walk over to our U.S. Capitol where we meet. And typically, that meeting takes about an hour. After that hour, that's when most of our hearings begin. I serve on two committees in the House of Representatives. I serve on the Energy and Commerce Committee, where I was elected vice chair of that committee. So I have a little bit more responsibility than the average member. And I also serve on the Committee on Homeland Security. And you can have a day where both of those committees are meeting. They have subcommittees. So I serve on multiple subcommittees. Those subcommittees may be having hearings. It may be a full committee hearing. I must attend those hearings, but the evening before, I have to make sure that I review all of the hearing material. So I know the subject matter. I know the questions I want to pose to our panelists of experts, to secretaries of various agencies in the federal government. These are the people who come before us in these hearings. So we start off at the Democratic caucus meeting. We move into a hearing process, or another alternative is there may be a press conference on Capitol Hill. And so I may depart from that meeting to a press conference that is located somewhere on the Capitol grounds, and then attend a hearing that at 10 a.m. is typically also when the floor of the House opens up. And when the floor of the House opens up, you have an opportunity to make a speech directly to your constituents. So I may have subject matter that I want my constituents to be aware of, and I want the entire United States to be aware of as a model coming from my district. I may go to the floor of the House of Representatives. So our mornings are really packed full of activities. I then, by about noon, have meetings. And these meetings are with various caucuses that I may be a member of. I'm a member of the Caucus on Black Women and Girls. I'm a member of the Congressional Caribbean Caucus. I'm a member and a co-chair of the Multicultural Media Caucus. They are a whole bunch of caucuses. And what are these caucuses? It's places where members from across the nation who have similar interests and concerns meet outside of the committee structure to discuss those issues and potential legislation that we can offer. Or we may have a guest speaker in that speaks to some of the subject matter that we are concerned about and want to advance in Washington, D.C. So we have caucus meetings maybe about midday or so. Then the afternoons, another series of hearings may come up. We will, in between lunch and the hearings, have votes called on the floor. We actually have bells that ring on Capitol Hill, and that lets us know that we have 15 minutes, no matter where we are, to make it to the floor of the House for the first series of votes before that vote is closed. So when that bell rings, of the estimated 300 million people in the United States of America, there are 435 individuals, I'm one of them, who make our way to the floor of the House of Representatives in the United States Capitol to cast our votes on your behalf. That's why it's called the House of Representatives. And our titles, while people call us Congresswoman, we're also called Representative. And that's because we represent the interests of the people within our own constituencies and in the aggregate, the people of the United States of America. Once that day of voting is finished, a series of receptions begin, where we meet with various groups who may be visiting in Washington, D.C. It could be your alma mater from college. It could be a special interest group like the Brooklyn Chamber of Commerce. There are many different groups that come to Washington, D.C. I may be even called during the day to go back to my office because a group of Girl Scouts have come to Washington. They're from Brooklyn, New York, and they want to meet with me and tell me everything that they're doing. We want to take photos together, or they may even come over and meet me in the Capitol so that we can take photos on the steps of the Capitol building. This all can happen in one day in Washington, D.C. So you have to have your stamina up. You have to eat your Wheaties. You have to be on top of your game. But I enjoy it immensely.